Welcome to the Vector Garden. In this video, we're going to talk about relative, absolute, and the zigzag effect, which is quite special as regards this relative and absolute thing. We have seen in another video that there is this relative and absolute setting and what it's there for. So I'm going to effect and apply roughen. And I'm going to set it to absolute and increase the detail so that we get a uniform look of these two objects regardless of their size. Let's increase the size a little and get less detail. Just like this. Okay. And you see, this is uniform. So we've got a uniform look of those. So let's go to these two and let's apply zigzag, like so. And you see, it's set to absolute by default. So zigzag is set to absolute by default. And we see, well, that's not uniform. So these two look wildly different. Why does that happen? And you see, the size is set in an absolute unit. So it's 3 millimeters. Let's reduce that a little, like so. But still, they look so different. And if we set that to relative, then we get something that looks more like it's kind of the same, but actually it's not, because those zigzags, they have a completely different size. But this time the amount of ridges is the same, and that's why they look kind of similar. So what's the reason why this is happening? I'm going to set that to absolute again so that we can see it better. And that's happening because of this setting. It sets the ridges per segment. So the number of ridges is the same on both the objects because this zigzag effect sets a number of ridges or points of these per path segment. So each path segment, regardless of its length, has the same amount of ridges in it. So in order to get the same kind of effect on it, what you need to do is select this one and reduce the amount of ridges. So let's go to Appearance and go in here and reduce that, and then somehow we can make them look more similar, but actually we can't. So this is something that happens because of the way this effect works. And this is even more apparent when you have this kind of stroke, or let's make a different one. So I'm going to draw it with the pen tool, and let's have 2 segments on this path, and one is short and the other one is longer. So let's apply a color to this, like so. And we have a short path segment and a longer one. And let's go to Effect, Zigzag, and let's make more ridges so that you see it. And you see, it makes 15 ridges per segment. So 15 here and 15 there. And because that path segment is longer, that's because they are spaced out more. That is something you can't solve in the effect. The only way to solve this would be to have more path segments in here. And in order to get that, of course, you do not want to add anchor points to it. Because first, that would be a lot of work. And second, you do not want to ruin your editability. So that's why you wouldn't do that. But thankfully, you can use the roughen effect to do it for you. So what you can do is go to Effect, Distort and Transform, Roughen. And let's have roughen before zigzag. So this looks bad. Now let's go into roughen again. What you need to do is set the size to 0 and then the detail to some lower value. And you see they are spaced out evenly. Great. And then you go into zigzag and reduce the amount, and you get equally spaced out ridges of your zigzag, because roughen makes it differently. So here we see zigzag, which has ridges per segment, and roughen, on the other hand, sets a detail in number of points per inch of this path. So it spaces them out evenly along the path, and that allows us to get even zigzags on the path.